My previous speaker, Mr. James, did too nice, so I'm not really proud of myself. So let's just start. Several months ago, I heard that I would be doing this TEDx talk. Actually, but I didn't know what I need to do because the organizers of this speech gave me only one keyword, the presence, and I had to make a meaningful speech on this topic. And to tell you the truth, I started to write this speech just a few days ago, so Saturday. The only thing that I did before when writing this speech was conducting a small survey. I directly asked my friends, families, teachers, and the other people I knew, what do you think is the best present? Well, there are many, several different answers, but there was one overwhelming answer. And I bet you can guess what it was. Can anyone guess what it was?
Money.
Yes, money. It was money. Most people answered that money would be the best present. Yeah, as you see here. And it seems true. I love money. And you love money. We all love money. However, I believe that we need to think again before considering money as the best presence. So here is the definition of the word presence in Oxford Dictionary. A thing given to someone as a gift. Yes, it says a thing given to someone, but that someone might not be you. In other words, you might be the side of a giver, not a receiver. In that case, would money still be the best presence? Would you like to give millions of dollars to your friend as a birthday present? At least I wouldn't. Therefore, I came up with the idea that we need to consider a lot of things before deciding the best presents. And I have my four criteria based on this idea to decide the best presents. So the first, the most importantly, is it worth the receiver? A worthless present would be just meaningless. And second, can the giver afford it? As I have already mentioned, you don't always get presents. You also give presents to the others. So you need to be realistic. And third, is it durable? We don't want to get presents that are brought in a day, right? And fourth, is it general? The best present must be the best in most situations. Whether it's on a birthday, on Christmas, on Halloween, on Valentine's Day, or on the other days, it must be the best, always. So, with these four criteria, I have evaluated some kind of presents that my friends offered as the best presents. So let's see. First was money that I have already discussed and gave low point to the second criteria. And another was a girlfriend. A girlfriend is a good present, but I realized that girlfriends do not last long. So they're not durable enough. And another was the high test score. I think my friend answered like this because I conducted this survey right after the test. Since I think great test scores are neither easily affordable nor general, so it cannot be the best present. There were many other different answers, but I had really hard time to find a proper answer. And at last, I found one present that meets all four criteria. It was a memory. Memories are valuable, that's the first. And anyone can give memories to the other people, that's the second. And important memories are durable, that's the third. And everyone wants to share and make their precious memories with other people, that's fourth. Is it perfect? One of my personal example that explains the value of memory as a present. So let's start. I have a friend, and I met him years ago. When I met him for the first time, I hated him. I really hated him. Seriously, I didn't like his appearance. I didn't like his characteristics, and I didn't like his accent and almost everything. However, I don't know why, but sometimes I play with them. I don't know why. And sometimes I fall with them, and sometimes I cooperate with them. Now, again, I don't know why, but he became one of my closest friends. Since I hated them, no visible presents were given to each other. However, the memories that I have made with him have never gone to anywhere. Those memories are precious for me, and I believe that I will never forget them. And even though I still don't really like him, at least I will cherish his presence that he gave for me. And as you can see from my experience related to my friends, the only thing I got from my friends was a memory. However, I didn't need any other present because that was better for me than any other presents. Oh, guys, to tell you the truth, I got lost. I forgot the speech. But this will be a memory to you, so I'm giving you a present. Sorry, I got lost. So let's continue. So I believe that my experience shows that the memory will be the best present, right? And it's not costly, but also valuable. Finally, I want to ask some questions to you guys. Do you have any precious memory? I bet you do. And did you make that memory with other people? I bet you did. Will you forget it? I bet you won't. But what is the best present? I bet you answer is the memory. Thank you.